South Carolina inmates on death row will now have to choose between the electric chair or a firing squad amid a shortage of lethal injection chemicals. Under the previous law, inmates who don't choose the electric chair are automatically scheduled to die by lethal injection. They have all chosen that method that now can't be carried out. So the big question, what happens now? The state will organize a firing squad and resume executions. This after 10 years. That is, unless the law is challenged in court. Joining us to talk about this is the original executive director of Justice 360 and the current Cornell Law School professor, John Bloom. John, thanks for being here. We appreciate it.
Sure. Happy to be with you.
All right. So the nonprofit is already signaling a lawsuit over this new law, calling the execution inhumane. So I get the inhumane. So is it, what exactly are you going to oppose here? The idea of capital punishment to begin with?
No. Well, I mean, to be clear, I was formerly director of Justice 360. I don't work there anymore, so I'm not involved in the litigation. They're going to file a suit, or it has been filed, from what I understand from talking to Lindsey Vann, the executive director, challenging the law on vagueness grounds. There are a lot of things that are unclear about it. For example, if you choose lethal injection and they say they can't do it, which I'm pretty sure they can't do, do they automatically electrocute you, or do you then get to pick the firing squad if that's your second option? But I think an important part of this story that's been missed is that there's really no strong evidence that they couldn't get the drugs. I mean, seven other states in the last 2 years and the federal government have been able to carry out executions using lethal injection, which the Supreme Court of the United States has repeatedly said is the most humane method. So it seems like this new bill got passed on this sort of manufactured crisis where the drugs really should be available because all these other states have been able to secure them.
All right. Assuming they don't get them, though, proponents of the bill, they say the families of the victims, you know, they deserve to see justice done, whether it's by firing squad, lethal injection or electric chair, and that they're entitled to see the death row inmate executed. How do you feel about that?
Well, I mean, I understand these people have been sentenced to death. I'm just saying I have not seen the case made that they can't get the drugs. If they, you know, can't, obviously there is a constitutional challenge to electrocution. The last state courts to hear a constitutional challenge to it were Georgia and Nebraska, both very conservative state courts, and they said that electrocution was unconstitutional because, number one, there's no evidence that it immediately renders the person unconscious, and there's strong evidence that they effectively just cooked the person to death. And so they found it to be unconstitutional. The firing squad, really people know less about it because it's used so infrequently. It's never been used in South Carolina. I've seen autopsy photos for a book that I wrote about the death penalty, and it's horrible what that does to a body to shoot them. So there could be substantive challenges to these as cruel and unusual punishments. But I think the main thing the state should be doing is really trying to get the drugs like the other states have done.
All right, John, interesting topic to talk about today. We appreciate you being part of the conversation. We really do.
Sure. Happy to help you out.
Thank you again.
Yep. Bye-bye.